Okay, so oops, sorry. I'm going to do original sound. Share screen. Okay. Okay, let's start.
Siberian Huskies are incredible dogs. They are loyal, brave, intelligent, and can be very affectionate with their human counterparts. For these reasons and many more, their popularity has skyrocketed in recent years. And because viewers can't get enough of these wonderful pooches, today we're bringing you a video devoted exclusively to them. Keep watching to discover 10 things you probably didn't already know about the Siberian Husky. Number 1. They're close to being wolves. Possibly due to its pointed ears, piercing eyes, and pronounced snout, the Husky is one of the most wolf-like dogs. However, recent studies have shown that the dog is not directly descended from the wolf, but is instead a very close relative. Number 2. Can have eyes of different colors. Having each eye be a different color is something known as heterochromia. This benign aspect is usually due to a hereditary genetic mutation. Heterochromia is also present in other animal species, including humans. Number 3. They adapt to different environments. The Husky is a dog which can adapt without problems to cold and icy climates. Its coat is a testimony to its origins in Siberia, where they derive their name. Surprisingly, however, they are able to adapt to more temperate climates. The same cannot be said for other Nordic dogs such as the Alaskan Malamute, which often suffers from intense heat. Number 4.
Sorry. I'm going to mute you guys. Okay, let's continue. Where is it gone?
They have a unique capacity for vocalization. The Husky is a particularly talkative dog, able to emit a large variety of sounds. They also stand out for their howl, which can be heard up to 15 kilometers away. Some Huskies even seem to sing, talk, and even whine, although it is quite unusual for them to bark. Number 5. It is one of the oldest dogs in the world. The Husky is a dog which was originally raised by the Shukshi tribe in northern Siberia. While these dogs had certain work-related functions such as sledge pulling, they were also important members of the community, sleeping in the same bed as women and children to keep them warm, as well as protect against intruders and wild animals. A recent study which analyzed more than 161 domestic dogs found that the Siberian Husky is considered the fourth oldest dog in the world. Number 6. The Snow Dog. It is no secret that Huskies love the snow. Virtually all individual Huskies show some interest in it, likely due to profound impact it has had on their history. Number 7. They were born to run. Along with the Shukshi tribe, Huskies worked as sledge dogs, transporting food and supplies from one place to another. Contrary to what some people believe, they did not usually carry sledge for people. They were chosen for this task for various reasons, including their resistance to the cold, as well as their stamina during long journeys. The sled was pulled by a score of dogs, and each of them played their own specific role. Number 8. Fits with different types of family. YouTube is full of cute and funny videos of Siberian Huskies, but why are they so popular? They are undoubtedly an excellent playmate for children, a member of a team when it comes to going on hikes, and a sensitive and affectionate dog in a day-to-day life. Its character is unique and variable, so much so that you must strive to keep them steadily amused and offer different types of enrichment. Number 9. Was the Husky a war dog? If we think of war dogs, the first breed which comes to mind might be the German Shepherd. They have been used as messenger dogs, rescue dogs, and even for mine detection. However, the Husky also excelled during the Second World War, carrying out transport and communication tasks. Number 10. Balto, an unprecedented hero. By far, one of the most striking stories about the Siberian Husky as a breed is that of the dog Balto. His popularity in different lore is such that a Spielberg-produced film was produced in 1995 detailing the story, with two sequels following some years later. It all began in 1925 when a large number of children contracted delirium in a town called Nome, Alaska. Faced with the near impossibility of receiving medicine, a group of men and their dogs decided to set out on a dangerous journey to save the lives of the village children. Some men and dogs died, including the guide dogs. However, Balto took over as leader of the pack despite having no prior experience. Fortunately, after 5.5 days, they reached their destination. The dogs were hailed as heroes and appeared in newspapers across the country. Were you inspired by any of these husky facts, or were you already an expert?
Okay, so I hope you all like the video. It's very cute, the husky. The name of the dog is called Husky. So I'm going to show you some dogs, in famous dogs in history of art, okay? So first of all, let's have a look. Let's try this way. Yeah. Okay, so let's have a look. First of all, let's look at some dog by himself, okay? So just painting of dogs. So this is a black, I can't remember the artist now. So when you do your painting, think about what your dog is doing. Is anything in his mouth? Is he running or is he sleeping? Look at this. Why does he paint two dogs, Mary? What do you think? Why does he paint two dogs together? This painting is 100 something years old. Okay? Because if you put one, look, if I paint one dog, I can only see the side. Yeah? I don't know what his face looks like. But if I paint another one like this, then I know what the face looks like as well, but I don't know what his legs looks like, but his legs is here. So when you do composition, try to pay attention.
Can you make it even bigger?
That's fine, that's big enough. 你们画的时候记得有一个是, 你看为什么画两个? 一个是侧面, 一个是正面, 这样它的构图又比较完整, 又可以看到整个狗, 又可以看到腿, 又可以看到正面, 又可以看到侧面, okay? And then this is a Chinese kind of painting, very famous Chinese painting. But what is dog doing? Is he doing tickle tickle? He's doing tickle tickle on his neck. Maybe he has a small insect. It's very itchy. Can you do that with your leg, Mary? It's quite funny. So, okay. Well, okay. Mary can actually do it. It's a bit scary. Okay. Then we look at. Okay. So there's another dog. This is a very looks expensive looking dog. No, don't touch it. So look at this. He's looking. Look at his face. He's looking on the side. We do the face. So when you want to do a portrait, the dog, anything, when the face is three quarters like this direction, it looks very three-dimensional. And try pay attention to the pose. Okay. So this is like a very elegant, 非常有气质的小狗,对吗? Very elegant dog. What about this one? Look! So now there's some portraits with dogs in it, because dogs are 狗狗是人类最好的朋友,对吗? Where's the dog? Do you remember this woman, Freda Kahlo? She painted monkeys with her in the past. Now she's painting a dog with her, because she doesn't have children. 因为他没有小孩，所以他怎么？上次我们看他和小猴子在一起，现在像小狗在一起。 Look at how tiny this dog is. It's a funny dog. So to remember, if you want to make something tiny, you put something big next to it. 你如果想画显得什么东西很小很小，你旁边画一个很大的东西，就会显得它很小很小。Okay? 这个小狗怎么在这里？ 好像这个妈妈也不喜欢它的样子。 Why is it like this? What about, this is a very standard portrait. This is by a very famous American artist, Sargent, John Singer Sargent. Okay, look at the dog. It's very fluffy.
What is fluffy?
A lot of hair. 小狗好多小毛毛,对不对? See? What about the girl? Her face is very smooth. 宝宝的眼皮肤很非常的光滑,对不对? 狗狗的皮肤上好多毛毛,对不对?
就有一个对比, pay attention to this when you do composition. What about this dog? Do you like this picture? 好不好看这幅画? It's by Gauguin, very famous French artist.
Can you use a bit of watercolor?
Well, you can, yes. When you make your painting, you don't have to paint the dog the same color as what you see. You can paint any color you want. But how do we know it's a dog? Because the shape, look at the shape and the legs. 虽然颜色什么都有, 但是你看它的形状, 它腿这种形状, 所以我们知道它是一个小狗。 你如果颜色也瞎弄, 形状也瞎弄, 我们就不知道你在画什么了。 Okay, lastly, this dog, look. What do you think when you see this dog?
The dog.
You can't see the dog, look. Whoop. Can you see him now? Can you see his face now?
Where there's nobody.
There's nobody. Is he very lonely?
Where there's nobody.
是不是很孤单啊, 这个小狗狗? 这个是一个非常有名的西班牙画家, Goya.
Mommy, does he live in the little home?
He looks very lonely. Very, look at this composition, yeah, where he put the dog is tiny, and it's very lonely. This artist, he painted, 就是很孤单, 没有人和他在一起. 因为他这个 artist, he painted when he was 70 years old, living by himself. 这个画家是70岁的时候他画的, 他自己住在一起, 他把它画在墙上了, he painted on the wall, okay? And then lastly, we're gonna look at this funny painting, look at that. We're gonna try to do this one. 我们试一试画这个好不好? Can you tell me what you see, Marie? Can you tell me what you see in this painting? What do you see in this painting? 你看这是画的是什么呀? Can you find a doggy in this painting?
I can't.
有没有小狗? Look, does it look like a doggy running? 有没有看下面有小狗在跑? 尾巴? 尾巴摇来摇去, 摇来摇去的, 然后腿在那, Yeah, does it look like that? 像不像? 像不像? 这个是就是100年前一个意大利的画家 Balla 非常有名, 他就画出名的, 因为从来没有人这样画过小狗, 对不对? 小狗有跑的感觉, looks like it's running. Yeah, so today, what about this? What do you think that is? Look at this line. This is a chain, 这就是圈小狗的绳子, 因为小狗在跑, 所以绳子也摆来摆去的。 然后这个人在走路, 在遛狗, 腿也排来排去的, and the woman is walking, that's his shoes. Look at this, his shoes is walking.
Why he's walking?
Because he's walking the dog. So, 我们先画一个这幅画, okay? 我们先, I'll try to show you how to do this painting, it's quite funny. And then we'll do another one, okay? So let's get your paper and and black baby emergency.
丢下来就好了。好了，现在是好了。
Oh, sorry, stop sharing.
这是什么？这是什么意思？这是要讲话吗？
猫讲的多好。 OK, 我们试着画这个小狗狗, OK? 这个小狗, 因为这个小狗很好玩, 在跑, 对不对? 啊, 这是一份很有名的画。 OK, so, get your brush. 来拿你的纸, 宝宝给你一张纸, 好吗?
别哭,
不能再扣了, 拿一张纸, 我们就画这个小狗狗就可以了, 不用画上面那个, OK, so let's do like this. So you just take your brush, let's try to get the shape of the dog, OK? 试着把小狗的身体, 脑袋在这里, 它的嘴巴在这里, 哇哇, 在这里, 耳朵也飞起来了, 跑起来, 耳朵也飞起来, 然后身体,
为什么耳朵飞起来了? 因为他跑步啊，
因为他跑得很快嘛，所以耳朵就飞起来了，然后把他身体先画下来，然后腿嘚嘚嘚嘚嘚嘚嘚嘚嘚嘚嘚嘚嘚嘚在跑，然后腿嘚嘚嘚嘚，然后尾巴摇来摇去。所以你先拿一个笔，先拿一个不要太大的笔就可以，把笔弄得干一点，先弄得干一点 ，OK？ 来，先弄得干一点，然后我们先弄得干一点，就是把笔用一个抹布或者纸巾把水上笔上多余的水蘸一蘸，拿着黑颜色就可以。我们先画小，把小狗的形状试着画下来。嘴巴，哦，脑袋。
你看，看妈妈画的，你看妈妈。
嘴巴，脑袋。
That is the next one.
Yeah, the mouse. The mouse has what? 上面一个，下面一个，对吗？嘴巴、脑袋，这样子就可以了。这是它的脑袋，有没有像小鸭子的脑袋？像不像小鸭子的脑袋？嘴巴、脑袋。OK， 然后。身体是这样子的。现在身体像不像一个 S？ 五，先往下，然后屁股起来，对吗 ？Look like that。五 ，try to get this shape first. Does it look like a S, Mary? Big S.And then you do a ear, pew, 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 pew. And then the legs. So let's do this leg. Legs. Oh, you can do one leg first. Oh. And then you do another leg. 你的腿有那么长吗？宝宝，你的小狗腿有那么长吗？然后我，然后它腿再这样。因为它跑啊跑啊，就有很多腿，就会变成很多腿。Look, it's a multiple leg. This is for content. It's a multiple leg dog. Whoop. And then 这个又很 dry brush, dry brush, multiple leg. Boom, 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 boom. Because he's running, he's running. Dry brush, 宝贝，可以你用干笔。OK. 就像那个开车一样。Whoop, whoop, 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 whoop.然后尾巴忘记画尾巴了，你再画一张吧，宝宝，你那个纸怎么画成那样了？看着形状 ，OK。尾巴也先用，先把尾巴画出来，先画一根尾巴，我 ，zup， 宝宝，你把那小狗尾巴 ，no，don't do that， 你重新画一张。No，if you destroy your painting，do another one。如果画坏了，你重新画一张，不要在同一张纸磨来磨去的 ，OK。What? 上面几根尾巴，下面几根尾巴，用干一点的笔，因为它在跑步，对不对？跑步的时候尾巴就这样摇来摇去，摇来摇去的。好了，这就可以了。然后它的身体有一点虚虚的，如果你想画，可以再画一个，就用干笔，在旁边再画一层。哦，身体也是虚虚的，跑，因为它跑嘛，跑的时候我们就看不清楚了。哦，嘴巴这里虚虚的，像不像小狗？嘚个哒，嘚个哒，嘚个哒，嘚个哒，嘚个哒，嘚个哒，嘚个哒，嘚个哒，嘚个哒。我的小狗已经跑，宝宝你画太慢了，妈妈小狗已经跑掉了。哦，这还有一个拴脖子的东西在这里。
拴脖子是用干什么
？OK。
妈妈，我再画一个。
就像项链一样的 ，OK。你先，然后你看着这个狗狗的形状，宝宝你不要瞎画好吗？然后。腿对，就是这个大大粗一点的，很粗的 S 型，然后腿是很细很短的，哒个哒哒个哒哒个哒哒哒这样跑。怎么样？好。然后呢，我们现在学一学哈。啊！怎么没有带围裙？天哪！救命！救命啊！救命啊！行了，你先给他戴那个吧，总比没围裙好。快快快 ！OK， 我们看一看这个字啊，看这个字像不像小狗 ？Look at this character. Does it look like a little dog?
No.
不像。这是我们祖先写小狗就是这样写的，这不嘛，耳朵这个两个腿嘛，尾巴两个腿，耳朵尾巴。 快点穿上。OK， 那你把这个收起来，它不用画了。走吧，你走吧。
快点，快点穿上来。
快点，快点。
OK， 然后看很久很久，然后呢，过了一段时间，我们就把它变成这样子写了，我们把它竖过来，把小狗竖起来。现在我们这样写，这个字念什么 ？Look， we learned this character before. What is it, Mary？ 这个字念什么？这个字念什么？
玛丽，
怎么看不到了？这个字念什么 ？Look， 这个是不是？这什么字？大小的大，对吗？大小的大，但上面带一个点点，就是犬，就是小狗的意思。现在我们的小狗，小狗是这样子，反犬旁，就是这样子，就很多汉字都有反犬旁。When you see this in Chinese character, it means it's some kind of animal. Marie, can you look? When you see this in Chinese character.It means it's some kind of animal. 这个就是现在我们写小狗的狗字 ，OK？
这个你是不是你自己画的？
这是我自己画的呀，你也不听。OK， 现在我们试一试画这个。Shall we try to do a husky? Because husky is Julia's favorite dog. OK, we've done a little famous dog. Let's put him here. Let's try to do a little husky, OK?And then afterwards, you're going to decide where the husky is and what is around him. Okay? 你不画妈妈以后再也不教了。
好的。
Okay, so we're going to try to do a little husky. Does it fit? Okay, first you look at the shape.You look at the shape of this dog.
快点，快点，看你画新的了，快点。
Can you look? 你把灯弄一下。
你看这个
灯。灯已经生气了。Look at the shape of the husky, okay? Does it look like a big L? Look, L. Does it look like an L, Mary? Does it look like an L? Bzz. Oops. What did I do? Sorry. Does it look like an L? Yeah. And what about here? Look. So he's got a head like this.Then the neck is like this. It's very fat. Look, Marie, can you look at the image? It's very fat. 这个脖子厚厚的，前面像不像一个半圆？ Look. 前面像不像一个半圆？后面像不像一个小小的半圆？对吗？对吗？然后你看一看，脖子拐弯 ，where the L is turning， 脖子拐弯的地方是不是腿在下面？因为它脑袋很重啊，对不对？When the neck is turning, the leg is supporting it, supporting the body. So the leg, the position of the leg, look at where the position of the leg is. 你看看腿的位置在什么地方。What about this leg? Is it straight?
No.
No, it's like that. And what about this leg? Is it the same as this leg?
No.
Which one is fatter? Which one is, 哪个比较粗? The one on the back, look, it's fatter. It's like a big circle here, oval shape here.然后毛毛的尾巴 ，OK， so let's try to do this。你先用比较用沾黑色的墨，然后用比较浅的 ，look this kind of 比较浅的墨就可以 ，OK。我们先我们试一试，可能会比较难，你们试一试，尽量画一下。
玛丽，你好好待着行不行？
你就想象，你想象你现在用你的笔在抚摸你的小狗 ，Imagine you're touching the dog with your brush。You're touching him with your brush. Ah, little doggy, you're so cute. Okay. So I'm going to see if we can fit it here. Does it fit? Okay, so first of all, let's try to do the fit, to do the head. Try to get the shape of the head. 先把狗脑袋的形状，先大概脑袋大概大小，不，放在画下来。
你那是往下点
的，
那图往下。
没事，那个耳朵不用。OK， 狗狗的特点是什么？它们有长长的什么呀？鼻子对吗 ？They have very long nose because they can smell a lot of things we can't smell. So when you do hide and seek with a doggy, doggy will always find you, Mary, because they have a special nose. Yeah.
They have a special nose.
Because their nose, they can smell a lot of things you can't smell. Oops. Okay, so do remember the L. So you do the L.Stop touching me. 就是一个小小的半圆，这边一个小小的半圆，对吗？ And you do the L. Look, This is fatter, this is thinner. 前面比较粗，因为它肚肚在前面，后面比较细，因为它在跑啊跑啊跑，所以后面全都是肌肉，对吗？你说是往下的，这个呢往上一点。OK。然后呢，我们把这个腿 ，remember 刚才说的腿在什么位置？腿在转弯的位置，因为它要 support 它的上面 ，because you need to support the big body. So you put the leg here. And look at the leg. This one 前面是斜的，后面是直的。OK。OK， 我这个，你们就这样看吧，因为我这个不是很好，放不下。哎，等后面的就腿，后面的腿是什么位置？看一看，后面的腿是一个圆圆的，对不对？然后 remember it's not straight, it's going this way, okay?然后一个小小毛毛的尾巴，我，OK， so like this, you got the big shapes, right? We have the ears. Then you can start putting on some dark shapes. So take a little bit more paint, a little bit more dark paint.With some water. 今天有点像画水彩一样，画的稍微深一点。OK， 先画比较深的位置。And then when you do the brush, because 你在你的笔的前面，笔的笔头的比较墨比较深，笔的后面墨比较浅，所以如果你这样子画的话，你看上面就比较深，底下比较浅，所以你把这个深的地方对着最深的地方 ，like that.Okay. 然后呢，再蘸一点水，我们把他身上的这个 ，you know, try to color it， 还是这样子。你看，哎呀，这个不是一个 good example。对，就是蘸，你蘸的水越少的话，它就越浅。OK， then you can do就像你们在书上填涂颜色一样，把它涂一涂颜色。尾巴是圆的，所以you need to have this. 尾巴最后尾巴是一个白白的尾巴。You can have something like that. And I'm gonna do the face.还有小耳朵，把最黑的地方先放进去，后面很就基本就画完了。耳朵是这个形状的，在这里。 鼻子，小狗的鼻子，我。嘴巴，你就想象你的拿你的小你的笔，在摸这个小狗。Imagine you're touching little dog with your brush. Okay, then you just keep doing it until you're happy. You can add some dark stuff, add some light stuff. Whoop. Maybe here, whoop. To be darker, whoop, like that. Is it a little bit fat?我们把这个狗弄得胖一点吧，胖胖狗比较可爱。嗯，这里处理的不是很好，我们把它的肚子弄得圆一点。Oops。然后就可以了，差不多就可以了 ，OK? Oops, sorry. That was a small mistake. If you make a mistake, it's like watercolor. You just put a lot of water and you can correct it with a rug.对了吧？OK， 然后如果你想让它显得比较白的话 ，Remember what he said， 就像我们画 snowman， you want to make it white， if you want to make something white， you can just carve it， look， you carve it， 就把它周围的东西变得很黑，它就会显得很白， look。你看它如果这边如果你想它显得很白的话，就把它给对吗，把它给勾画，把它就像我们画 snowman 道理是一样的，把这些其他的地方变黑它就显得白了， OK。前面也是 you want to show him his white very white here, make it very dark.是不是能可以看出来它比较黑啦？Okay, 就是 so if you want, you can do, if you want, you can do a, you can do you know, you can put in the background where 这个 husky 周围还有什么，还有什么东西。OK， 你可以 ，if you want， 你可以把这些再画一些细其他的细节。这个狗狗周围还有什么？有没有小朋友啊？whatever。OK， so I put this the husky here. You can see like this. So we're going to play some music now. 哎，好像还有个字没有学啊，还有个尾巴的尾字。这个字我们还没有学，宝宝，你看这个字我们今天要学一下，尾巴的尾字。这个字我们学过。你看这个字我们学过是什么 ？What is this character？ What is? Can you have a look? What is this character? 羊毛的毛字，对不对？加上这个就是尾巴的尾字 ，OK？ 小狗尾巴的尾字，因为小狗尾巴也是毛毛的，对不对 ？OK， so I'm gonna play some music. You can sing the song while you finish your painting. OK？现在几点？哇天，已经快第五点。Okay, I'm gonna do the song and then we'll finish and have a look at everybody's painting, okay? Let's do your screen. Baba, 你今天都没有画画啊。Where is the bingo?
Fast and affordable rides at the tap of a button.Bolt, the smartest way to move.
Okay. Marie, I can't see anything. Marie?
Mary, I can't see anything.
Right.
So we've done, today we've done a little husky. Well, we tried to do a little husky. And we've done the funny dog of Balla. The runny dog, okay?
Funny dog.
Funny dog. Okay, I'm gonna stop.